So here comes a song from Garth Brooks that is really expanding the scope of freedom for us. This ain't coming from no prophet. Just an ordinary man. When I close my eyes, I see the way this world shall be when we all walk hand in hand. When the last child cries, or a crust bread. When the last man dies for just words that he says, when there's shelter over the poorest head, then we shall be free. When the last thing we notice is the color of skin, and the first thing we look for is the beauty within. When the skies of the oceans are clean again, then we shall be free. We shall be free. We shall be free. Stand straight and walk proud, 'cause we shall be free. Free to love anyone we choose, when this world big enough for all different views, when we all can worship from our own kind of views, then we shall be free. Oh, we shall be free. We shall be
July focus today. I'd like to thank Roy Martin Bradbooks back here. Thank you so much. And speaking of Roy, this coming Friday, that's this Friday, true.
That is this Friday.
Did I just remind you?
It is
this Friday.
Yeah.
So it's our second date night happening right here under our tree, an outdoor concert with homemade ice cream from Nancy Hutto. And the music guests will be the Solar Brothers Band. So that includes Roy Martin Bradbooks, with Paul Frazier. How many people know who Paul Frazier is? So I'm just going to say, you've seen Roy play, and you've seen him up here, and you know some of his songs. If you haven't seen Paul Frazier play, isn't Paul Frazier fun to play with, Roy?
Oh, yeah.
He's awesome on the guitar and just his demeanor and everything he offers at the microphone and on stage. Super great.
And fun.
Fun, yeah. Yeah. And they've been letting me play with them. So I'm so glad because they do let me. And I thought they should call it Brenda and the Solar Brothers, but they didn't let me. Just kidding.
Maybe just Brenda's Band.
Well, I might have to do a little more work if that was true. But yeah, they let me play some percussion and sing some harmonies. It's just so much fun, really, to just be on stage with those two guys who are so talented on guitar. You'll hear some of their own songwriting and covers that are fun. Under the Tree, just a fabulous time. So that's this Friday at 7 p.m. for our second date night. And just come, and it's a love offering donation. We take a love offering during the concert, and then we split that with the musicians and CSL, and it seems to work really great for people and for us. So thank you in advance for attending that. Another fundraiser coming, or that we're in the process of right now, is a CSL cookbook. And so if you have recipes, and I know you all do because I've been to the potlucks, recipes that people are constantly asking, how did you make that, or can I have your recipe? Now is the time to put it in the CSL cookbook. There's pages over on the handout table, and Joni, could you raise your hand? Yeah, so Joni is in charge. She's on our core council, and she has taken up this project, and she is such a smart woman. She's got all of her ducks in a row. So if you, well, I don't know about all of them, but about the cookbook, anyway. Just kidding, Joni. So if you have questions about that, please visit Joni. You can take like as many of those as you want, one recipe per sheet. You can take as many as you want and fill them out. In fact, we're looking for a lot of recipes. So please do, questions. Don't get caught up in the categories over here. Nothing is for certain. I think we can make up our own categories too. We can do whatever we want, I think. Knowing CSL, we will do whatever we want, right? So please, bring your recipes back in. We're trying to have this together and ready to sell at Christmas. And if for some reason that doesn't work, we'll sell it when it's ready, right? Okay. Perfect. She wants them by the beginning of August. That was for me. She said at the end of August. Yeah. Good. Okay. Okay. One more thing. This is so exciting. I need a drum roll. Yeah. We have a dinner for eight. Woo! I'm going to read it. So a dinner for eight. Let me explain just a little. Someone, one of our members, has offered to host a dinner for eight people, and how that works is you give a donation to the center of $25, and then you go, and this host or hostess or both provide all the dinner and whatever their dinner for eight has with it, and then all of that money goes to CSL. So grateful for somebody coming forward and hosting a dinner for eight. I'm going to read it here. Dinner for eight, featuring a taste of northern New Mexico with fresh local garden produce. Saturday, August 12th at 5:30 p.m. at the home of John and Myrna Griffin. It has their address here. Appetizers and drinks in New Mexico style courtyard. Gazpacho, garden fresh pico de gallo and tortilla chips, sangria, Mexican beer, and non-alcoholic beverages. That's all in the courtyard. And then we move to dinner in the dining room. Green chili chicken enchiladas, chamaya red chili cheese enchiladas, and calabacitas. And then we go to dessert on the patio, which is facing the San Juan Mountains, for margarita cheesecake. So I have, now this is only eight people, okay? I have a sign-up sheet, and you can't go till after the service is over. Sorry. Somebody want to guard the door? The sign-up sheet is on the bulletin board across from the bookstore, over by the bathrooms. So 8 people will sign up to go to this August 12th. So grateful. Isn't that fun?
Are they open today for lunch?
So thank you, John and Myrna. I think I'm finished with announcements. How about that? Oh, is that because I'm finished or because I did a good job? Either one, I'll take it through. Okay, so let's speak our vision statement together now as we begin our service. This center offers a path for awakening to the realization of oneness. Open hearts, inspired life, empowered love. Our spiritual community welcomes all people to embrace oneness as the truth of our being. Together, we see a world of love, peace, and abundance for all.
Quiet place within my life.
breathing in the sacredness of this moment. I recognize this breath as the breath of life, so freely given, freely shared with each and everyone. And as I breathe this holy breath, I recognize that this is the Holy Spirit, the oneness, the allness of creation. This creation, this spirit, this divineness that expresses as the all good, as the unconditional love, the peace and the harmony and the joy of living, that this is our divine birthright, that we are filled with the allness of the holy breath, the breath of life. And as this breath flows through me, so freely given, I know that I am united with all that spirit is, that I am a part of this, that it is my birthright, and it is always here right now in this very present moment. And as I know this for myself, I know this for each and everyone. For each and everyone is that breathing presence of spirit, individualized in multiplicity, in diversity, in every living thing, in all matter of the universe. So accepting our oneness, our inclusion, and our freedom in this grand scheme of things, I speak this word, affirming that this is the knowledge, this is the breath that sets us free to choose how we may express in this world. That we are immersed in this freedom of choice, that we are immersed in this spirit to express our unique expression. And I declare for each of us that we release anything that is holding us back from demonstrating our magnificence and our freedom. I accept that we choose each moment to live this life so freely given, in awareness of our divine nature, in a higher consciousness of our unlimited possibilities to express fully in this divine wisdom, in this joy, in this power, in this harmony. And we freely express the creativity of life in our work, in our relationships. And we are free to declare and live our life purpose fully for all the infinity of the universe is ours right minute, this moment, as we are free to choose how we live our life. And for those requesting prayers in the prayer chest and the desires of your heart, I know that this freedom is expressing right now in its situation. And I accept and declare that that wholeness and perfection of spirit is being revealed, that each is guided, directed to a perfect outcome, to a fuller expression of life in all of its beauty, its harmony, its health, its abundance. Divine wisdom moves through each situation, guiding, directing, knowing with clarity that freedom that is being revealed for a greater yet to be. And I know this process is a healing experience happening right this moment. This service is blessed by the divine love that is shining forth from each one here today. And we are blessed and renewed by all that transpires through the volunteers of hospitality, of music, of the message. Everything here is an expression of the Spirit in action. And I give thanks for each and every one that has volunteered to make this a wonderful experience for each of us. So I give thanks for this truth of freedom that is ours to express. I give thanks for this being our identity for all times. And I am so grateful that this is the truth of our being. As I release these words, knowing the Spirit always says yes, that we are always in that divine yesness of the universe. So I just let go, knowing it is already so, as we join together and declare, and so it is.
Get ready, my soul. I'm diving in. Get ready, my soul. I'm diving in to the deepest. Cause here I go, deeper, deeper, deeper than I've ever been before. Here I go, closer, closer, closer to my sacred source. Here I go, deeper, deeper, deeper than I've ever been. Here I go, closer, closer, closer to my sacred source.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'd like to remind you of the prayer chest down the stairs to the left. If there is something that seems to be holding back some of your freedoms to express yourself fully, please put your concerns in the prayer chest, and the practitioner will be doing affirmative prayer for you this week. True freedom is always spiritual. It has something to do with your innermost being, which cannot be chained, handcuffed, or put in a jail. Rajneesh. And from Viktor Frankl, It is this spiritual freedom, which cannot be taken away, that makes life meaningful and purposeful.
Thank you, Lou. Between her prayer and her quotes, that's pretty much the message. So, one mind. Okay, so July, here we are. So the focus for the month of July, the whole month, will be present moment. And today we're going to focus a little bit on what is true freedom because of Independence Day. So we'll kind of keep that theme in there as well. I'm going to be reading a little bit of some Eckhart Tolle. Okay, so let's start out with the Eckhart Tolle quote or passages from his books. This one says, "The past has no power over the present moment. If your mind carries a heavy burden of past, you will experience more of the same. The past perpetuates itself through lack of presence. The quality of your consciousness at this moment is what shapes the future." That could be good news or bad news, right? The quality of your consciousness at this very moment is what shapes the future. So spiritual teacher and author Eckhart Tolle, and I know most of you are familiar, very familiar with him at this point. He wrote a book. His first book was called The Power of Now, The Power of Now. And his next book, and he's written other things as well. And I usually do work out of A New Earth. Love them both. I kind of think this was the idea and this is how to get to that idea. And I have messages of his, a little bit quotes and stuff, and then some commentary from moi about those. The book's intent is to be a guide to spiritual enlightenment by way of recognizing what is false within ourselves, and he calls that our ego, that creates our emotional problems. This understanding can then help transform our thinking and free ourselves to experience a more meaningful and joyful life. So the essence of Eckhart Tolle's book is this: by learning to live more in the present moment, we can experience a way out of suffering and into peace. Freedom from suffering and freedom in peace. And freedom to choose every moment to be in the present moment. Or not, right? So I'm just gonna intersperse some quotes with a little bit of commentary. And his first thing he says, "All negativity is caused by an accumulation of psychological time and denial of the present. Unease, anxiety, tension, stress, worry, which are all forms of fear, are caused by too much future and not enough presence. Guilt, regret, resentment, grievances, sadness, bitterness, all forms of unforgiveness are caused by too much past and not enough presence." So that was out of his book. These are out of his book, The Power of Now. So I love how he puts that, not enough presence. This is because we cannot be thinking about the past or the future and experience the perks that we get from being in that present moment. For the perks of the presence, that God within us, or the joy of the present moment, which is when? Right now, right? Right now. And then he says, accept, A-C-C-E-P-T, accept then act. Whatever the present moment contains, accept it as if you had chosen it. Always work with it, not against it. Did anybody's like hair go up when I said, as if you had chosen it? It's not so easy, is it? Accept whatever is happening in this present moment as if you had chosen it. Always work with it, not against it. Not to accept what is happening right now is to resist it, right? When we think it is wrong and we want it to be different, then we suffer. We hold our joy back. We limit our own joy by way of thinking that whatever's happening now is wrong for some reason, any reason. It's just wrong. We're resisting it. It shouldn't be this way. When we can accept it as if we had chosen it, it can work in our favor, no matter what it is. It can. God is always setting things up to work in our favor. Even if it was the most crappiest thing ever, we can still choose to accept it and then have it work in our favor. Remember, God is always for you. It is your truth wanting to express its greatness and glory through you at all times. It's painful for us when we block that truth or we block that flow of truth. We experience it as pain. So a question that we can ask is, what is this experience trying to reveal to me? Instead of resisting it, accept, what is it trying to reveal to me? Invite it with acceptance that is for you. Always work with it. Eckhart says, your entire life only happens in this moment. The present moment is life itself. Yet people live as if the opposite were true and treat the present moment as a stepping stone to the next moment, a means to an end. Man, I really remember when I really got that. When I really noticed myself doing just that. And how many times do we do this? I just need to get through this moment so I can get to that really important thing that's next, whatever it is. Can we start catching ourselves when we do this? Do we rush through this to get to that? Do we just use this moment as a means to get to the real life moment, the one that really counts? Do we hypnotically wash our hands, take a shower, pay our bills, clean our house, communicate with our spouse or our friends without being fully present or sometimes not present at all? This is where the practice of mindfulness comes. Who's familiar with mindfulness? Of course. And we have to practice it. This is a practice. When we open all of our senses to the experience before us, then we become receptive to more of God's glorious universe that is in that experience. When we open all of our senses, so oftentimes we shut off most of our senses. We don't experience it through all of our senses. And so we're shutting off that gloriousness of God's universe in that experience, even if it's just washing your hands. Staying mindfully present to the experience right in front of us, no matter how insignificant it may seem, then it sets us up to receive the blessings in that thing, in all things. It sets us up as a receiver of the blessings. When our mind is single-pointed on the task at hand, we begin to feel the presence within us. We feel purpose and meaning in life instead of just thinking about what our purpose and meaning in life is. We know That's with capital letters, K-N-O-W, capital. We know our purpose is to be present to God's universe. Present to God's abundance, beauty, and bounty. To be present to the unchanging spiritual universe that is behind this material world. Upholding this material world. To make ourselves available to the infinite intelligence causing this world to be is what our purpose is. And that's what gives us meaning. The mind of God, which directs and infuses itself into all of life. That's our purpose, to remember that. Remember this scripture. Thou will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee. So our job is to keep our mind stayed on that oneness, that God essence in and through everything. Eckhart says, the beginning of freedom is the realization that you are not the thinker. The moment you start watching the thinker, a higher level of consciousness becomes activated. You then begin to realize that there is a vast realm of intelligence beyond thought, that thought is only a tiny aspect of that intelligence. You also realize that all the things that truly matter, beauty, love, creativity, joy, inner peace, those all arise from beyond the mind. Then you begin to awaken. And we talk about thought a lot here, and it's very important because it's the beginning steps, right, of changing what is in your consciousness. And he says, that's a very small part of what's going on. It's good thought. Thought is like hooked up with spiritual mind treatment. So important. And he's talking about this presence beyond that. That's hooked up with meditation. Letting go of the thought, right? And experiencing the feeling of the presence within you. You remember the Sufi poet Rumi, quote, out beyond ideas of wrongdoing and right doing. Where is wrongdoing and right doing? That's the mind and the material thinking, right? The material world, wrong and right, the duality. So out beyond those ideas, there's a field. He says, I'll meet you there. When the soul lies down in that grass, the world is too full to talk about, right? Too full to have concepts and ideas about. I just want to be there. Eckhart goes on to say, the power for creating a better future is contained in the present moment. You create a good future by creating a good present. As soon as you honor the present moment, all unhappiness and struggle dissolve, and life begins to flow with joy and ease. When you act out of the present moment awareness, then whatever you do becomes imbued with a sense of quality, care, and love. He says, even the most simple action. So the ability to live in the present moment is the ability to live in the recognition of the presence of God within us, always recognizing the presence of God within us. When our actions are born out of spiritual thinking, we talked about that in class, there's spiritual thinking and there's material thinking. So spiritual thinking is recognizing the presence of God in not only within ourselves, but within all things. And when we take actions from that mindset, then our actions will have the qualities of goodness, of godness, of care, of love, even the most simple actions. Like a smile becomes imbued with that God quality. How powerful is that? Eckhart, die to the past every moment. You don't need it. Only refer to it when it is absolutely relevant to the present. Feel the power of this moment and the fullness of being. Feel your presence. I invite you to take a moment right now to feel your presence. Does anybody get a tingly feeling when you feel your presence, or even when you read, like you read spiritual material, or you hear it? Do you have some kind of tingle in your body, something really deep that says, Kripa, this resonates with me, right? A feel, or you might feel a wave of energy throughout your being, your body, uplifting you. When I said feel your presence, I hear a sigh like, oh, like I'm free in this presence, right? It's expanding you. You realize you're more than just your thoughts. You're more than just your mind. You're more than just your body. It expands you. I have to say, I am addicted to feeling my presence. Who's addicted to feeling your presence? Right? That's not a bad addiction. I want to live there so that my actions, no matter how small, are imbued with the quality and the care and the love that I want to share with. So I do everything I can to remember to use my outer life experiences to guide me to observing where my ego is deceiving me. Anybody have a deceiving ego? Oh, it's so tricky. So tricky, right? So our outer experiences can guide us to where we need to observe our mind. We need to observe what it is we're believing and thinking. And my outer life of experiences will show me my need and where I need to observe my mind, my own thinking, what thoughts are dominant in my life right now or in my life at this moment. We need to slow down. Let me say that again. I need to slow down. Take care of what is in front of me right now. Take care of this moment. Take care of what I have already created in my life before I create more. What have we created in our life, in our home, in our children, in my world, in our music, in our church, in my body, in my eating? What have I created in my life? Take care of what we've already created. Take care of this moment, and it will joyfully usher you into this moment. Always the present. Eckhart says, realize deeply that the present moment is all you will ever have. Make the now the primary focus of your life. Because now, this is me, because now is where the power of choice resides, which we talked about as well, both in her, I think, quotes and her prayer, which was fabulous again today. Lou, thank you so much for your fabulous prayers. She's awesome. The power to choose your thought is in the now. We always choose right now. The power to choose spiritual thinking instead of material thinking exists right now. It's the only time you can do it. So what is true freedom? Well, she talked about true freedom as well. True freedom? Freedom from fear and suffering? Freedom from the lie of duality? You know what I mean by that? That there's two and not one, that there's two powers, that there could ever be anything opposing the one God, life. true freedom is spiritual freedom. Freedom in truth, with capital T. The one truth, oneness. The freedom to live from spiritual thinking as opposed to material thinking, because we do have the freedom to think anything we want. No one can take that away from us. True freedom is to live every day, every moment that we can remember. Don't beat yourself up if you don't. Just remember. Start again. Out of our spiritual nature, to live out of our spiritual nature. By recognizing that there is a presence beyond our ego identity. So Eckhart talks a lot about the ego identity. He goes into detail about the tricky ego and how to, he doesn't badmouth it. Well, maybe he does, but he wants us to transcend believing in that, believing in the lie. Beyond our small, limited concept of ourselves, our very real presence, which is within us and really is us, the real you is your freedom, that spiritual freedom, that spiritual knowledge that God is all there is within me, God's presence, and you. I am appearing in the world as my concept of myself. Isn't that so interesting? I appear as my concept of myself. I have my own ideas that I carry about myself, as you do, who I believe myself to be. And yet, within my personal collection of memories and thoughts and emotions, which is like my individual consciousness, is the very spark of my divine creator. The truth of me. It is the truth of me because it was first, and then I was created. The spiritual came first, then I was created. And then what I did is I took these concepts and I created who I am. But what can we do? We can change our concepts, right? Change your thinking, change your life. We believe there is one creator of all. One creator of you, one creator of me. We believe we are all connected in the Christ consciousness. Jesus Christ lived in that Christ consciousness. He thought from that Christ consciousness. He acted from that Christ consciousness, which he knew was all one, right? God consciousness. So we are connected through our individual consciousness. And we have access to this God consciousness through this Christ consciousness, this Christ mind, which we all share collectively. We are all depositing into the central Christ consciousness, like the central Christ bank. We all make deposits, right? By way of our thoughts, emotions, and beliefs. In our individual consciousness. We need to ask ourselves, what are we depositing? What am I depositing? Remember, our outer experience is a reflection of our own individual self-concept, the way we see ourselves in all the areas of our lives, our beliefs about our worthiness and our goodness. We decide what we deserve and what we don't deserve. This is our individual consciousness. It takes only one person to change your life. You. As we raise the quality of our consciousness by raising our self-concept, by thinking God-centered thoughts and ideas about ourselves, which is the same thing that our spiritual brother Jesus Christ teaches, right? Same thing. We not only then raise our quality of life in every way, but we raise the whole of humanity because we are all connected in that one, in the Christ consciousness. We affect each other. So Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him. If you abide in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. So when we start fretting and fearing the future, anybody fret and fear the future? Maybe because of something that we did, maybe because of something somebody else did or said, usually yesterday or last year or even 40 years ago, we can remind ourselves about the truth of the goodness and the wholeness of God with these words of Eckhart Tolle. He said, "The quality of your consciousness at this moment is what shapes the future." This moment, what is the quality of your consciousness? We must take care of this moment only. So here we are, right back to the present moment. So if the past perpetuates itself by a lack of presence, then the presence must perpetuate itself by the fullness of presence, by staying in the present moment where God resides, always available, full, vital, alive, here, right now, for you. So I invite you to sit back, relax, and receive this message and song.
I am home.
All right. So as Dave sets the harp down and it says guitar, I just have a few mantras. So if you find yourself out of sorts, thinking, obsessing over a thought that is not serving you well, I just wrote down a few things that can instantly put you into the present moment. How about thank you? Can you remember that? Simple. Just thank you. That immediately will put you right here, where your power is, remember. How about I praise you in the name of love? I praise you in the name of love. I say that all over my house all the time, to everything. I praise you in the name of love. How about God is all there is? Bring your mind back. God is all there is. No need to worry. No need to fear. God is all there is. Even if the worst thing in the world happens right now, God is for me and all there is. Thou wilt keep me in perfect peace when my mind is stayed on thee. That's a promise out of scripture. Thou wilt keep me in perfect peace when my mind is stayed on thee. And so it is. How about, and so it is. And so it is. How about, and now I let it be. And now I let it be. Present moment right here. Let's all sing.
God, you are every mountain, God, you are every ocean, God, you are every canyon, every inch of earth and sky. God, you are every morning, God, you are every midnight, God, you are every moment, every second of my life. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below, everything I know is you. God, you are every sunrise. God, you are every moon glow. God, you are every starshine, every inch of earth and sky. God, you are every springtime. God, you are every snowfall. God, you are every season, every second of my life. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below, everything I know is you. Cause you are every breath I breathe, and your perfect love created me. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below, everything I know is you. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you. Everything above, everything below, everything I know is you. Everything I see, everything I do, everything I am is you.
Okay, as the ushers come forth, this is our time to consciously participate in the law of circulation. So, as we take our tithe, our gift in our hand, please know with me that this is a symbol of the abundance of God, that this expression comes to me freely and circulates freely, doing good. And so I gratefully let it flow into the world as the world flows through me in abundance. And our affirmation?
God is lavish, unfailing abundance, the rich, omnipresent substance of the universe.
I had a hammer, I had a rhythm board, I had a king all over this land. I had a danger, I had a warning, I had a love between my brothers and my sisters.
As they flow through this church, through our community, and through our world, spreading the abundance and the reception of abundance in all. And so it is.
So it is.
Thank you so much, Lou. So I would like to welcome anyone who is here for the first time, CSL. Welcome. I believe we have some coffee and maybe some refreshments, and I know we have good conversation, an awesome fellowship downstairs after the service, so we invite you to do that. Tamara will be walking around. She has a little device called the Square. If you choose to use your debit or credit card for anything, we take money here for tithes or anything, she can do that for you. The bookstore is open. I will be running around. If you have something you'd like to buy in the bookstore, just come and grab me and I will help you, or anyone can come grab me and pull me in there. So let's see, what else? The prayer chest. Down the steps and to the left, prayer request forms. Ask for the name of the person that you would like prayer for. That can be yourself or someone else, and the good that you desire. So that Lou is very clear when she takes those prayers home, the good that you desire, so that she can know you don't really have to desire that anymore. It's already within you. She'll know that for you. Changes consciousness. Remember, all connected in that Christ consciousness. Thank you so much, Lou, for your service to our center. Sign up for Del Dorado Days if you choose. And the dinner for eight. I know Myrna and John are watching. There's the camera. Hi, Myrna and John. So on three, I think we should, not on three, but after three, like one, two, three, say it, right? I'm so goofy.
We better rehearse.
We will. Let's say thank you, John and Myrna. Ready? One, two, three.
Thank you, John and Myrna.
Yeah. Okay. Sometimes I forget that camera's over there until I look at it the next day and I'm like, oh gosh. So, but I can edit, so that's good. This is too much information. Okay, let's see. Where are we? Claiming our good, right? Here it is. Claiming our good. Look at that. So we will say these things all together, all the way down, without stopping. Here we go. I will not worry about things I cannot control. I am exactly where I am meant to be. I am safe and secure. I am rooted in this present moment, and so it is.
I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. I'm in the right place at the right time. I am just where I'm supposed to be. Whoa.